Well, Election Day has come and gone, and whether you're feeling a huge sense of relief or you're feeling bitterness and resentment, there's one thing that is clear, and that is that this is an opportunity for learning and growing for all of us. Our country has never been more divided than it is right now, and this is a time in history when we have a choice of whether or not we stay divided or we work hard to come together so that we don't continue down a cycle of divisive polarization that's pulling us apart. Now, you may be feeling righteous anger about positions and facts that you have. You may be feeling genuine fear for yourself or others. You may be feeling resentment about the way that you've been treated, the way that others have spoken to you about your positions. And all of that is fair. All of that is justified. We're all entitled to our feelings and entitled to the way that we vote and the position that we have. But I ask you to consider what would happen if you channeled all of the energy and passion that you have about your positions and took that energy and moved it into conversations with people who don't think and feel the way that you do. Because we know one thing. We know that if we continue down the path of villainizing one another because we don't agree, that we will not be able to come together. And whether your party lost or won this election, we're going to be back here in 2 and in 4 years. And if we continue down the road that we're on, being so extremely polarized and, quite frankly, unable to have healthy conversations when we disagree, we're going to be in an even worse position then. So what we must do now, regardless of if the election results are the way that you wanted them or not, what we must do now is have the difficult conversations, the ones that are harder to do than ignoring someone, harder to do than attacking someone, but really sit down and learn from someone why they think the way they do and be able to share with them in a way that you can why you feel the way that you do. I ask this, we talk about this at the National Conflict Resolution Center, acknowledging that it's difficult, but acknowledging that it is necessary for us to be able to move forward as a society. Holding on to the hurt and anger can be important to move things forward, but in the end, it can only get us so far. We have to be able to move forward together. So we encourage you, we're here for you in the steps to do this. We're always holding conversations, dialogues, even trainings on how to have these very challenging conversations. And we know that this is the time to start that work so that we can see the improvement that can take us forward from here on out.